Welcome to today update. Please subscribe and check notification box to get all breaking news alert. A prominent Republican candidate for Senate in Virginia called Democrats the party of criminals, communists, crackheads, and weirdos at a get out the vote rally on Sunday, and mocked the transgender candidate for good measure. The comments from Corey Stewart, who narrowly lost the Republican gubernatorial primary to Ed Gillespie this summer and is now running for U.S. Senate, came at a rally at a Virginia Beach church to galvanize Republican voters ahead of the election for governor just 9 days away. Gillespie had declined an invitation to attend the rally, which was sponsored by the national group Bikers for Trump. But Stewart was joined by one member of the Republican ticket, State Senator Jill Vogel, who is running for lieutenant governor. The other Republican on the slate, Attorney General candidate John Adams, was a last-minute cancellation. The event itself, and Stewart's remarks, illustrate the bind in which Virginia Republicans find themselves in the run-up to the year's most closely watched election on November 7. Gillespie, seeking to portray himself as a soft-spoken moderate, has publicly kept his distance from his one-time rival, and yet, because his fortunes are to a large degree in the hands of Trump-backing conservative activists, the general election has been shaped by Stewart in tangible ways. In the campaign's closing months, Gillespie has trained his fire on two subjects that Stewart and Trump have also embraced, the Latino gang MS-13, and the state's assemblage of monuments to Confederate generals. Stewart, the chairman-at-large of the Prince William County Board of Supervisors, branded himself during the primary as a sort of mini-Trump, and he has a flair for stunts that proved too much for even the Trump campaign. He was fired from his position as Virginia chairman of the Trump campaign for organizing a protest outside the Republican National Committee headquarters last October. His goal was to shame Republicans who abandoned the presidential nominee after the publication of the infamous Access Hollywood tape, in which Trump bragged about committing sexual assault. During the primary, he built a following among conservatives by traveling to Charlottesville to protest a proposal to remove a statue of Robert E. Lee. The white supremacist Richard Spencer would travel to the same spot 3 months later. On Twitter, he declared, "Politicians who are for destroying the statues, monuments and other artifacts of history are just like ISIS.